Jeremiah 10 verse 13, it is written, the people in the world, they are boasting up the horses. Some others are boasting up their chariots, but we boast up the Lord. Some are boasting up their riches. Some are boasting up their beauty. A day comes when everything passes away. But when you still hold on to the Lord, still you move on, problems come, nothing happens to you. Joseph is being tortured, but he says, okay. He's thrown into the lion's pit. He says, okay. God was with him. God was with Joseph. Again and again the Bible says, God was with Joseph. His life was miserable. Removed from the father. As a child removed, the mother is gone. Now the father is gone. Now the place where he was working is thrown away. He is in the jail now. It's okay. Because God never left him. When you are born from heaven, though you go through many trials, still you are moving on. Nothing can stop you. You may be thrown into the lion's pit like Daniel. You move on. You don't get stuck up. Because you are moved by the heaven. When the heaven moves you, the earth cannot stop you. That's why in First John chapter 3 and in Revelation also, Revelation chapter 3 also is written, verse 7 and 8, when God opens the door for you, nobody can stop it, close it. When God closes a door, that is the end. You may be in the world, you may be crying, you may be doing, the Lord says, don't ask anymore. Moses behaves like a man of the flesh, and the Lord says, stop, you are not going to the land of Cana. Again, Moses comes and says, I did this, don't ask anymore, that's all. Door is closed. Paul is asking, Lord, the flesh, don't ask, my grace is sufficient for you. You have to handle with this. Don't ask to remove, I am going to remove your flesh, no. Door is closed. Many people, I think you are matured enough, I can tell you. Many people only think about the mercy of God. But there is also an element which is called terror of God. When you live in sin, the moment the grace is gone, the terror of the enemy will catch you, and it will destroy you. The moment, that's why God gives a gift through the Holy Spirit. I think you are matured enough to understand. God gives a gift called the fear of God. The fear of God keeps you with God, that the terror of God may not happen in your life. God gives you the gift of the fear of God, that you may not enter into the terror of God. So don't play. That's why the Bible says, we shape our destiny. The world passes away with all its glory. But if only you have committed your life for God, the will of God, you will look like Chiranjeevi. Telugulo cheptunnaru ee lokamu dani vyamoham kathinchipovunu kani devuni chittamunu neravechuvaru Chiranjeevi ga ee loka Chiranjeevi gaadu Chiranjeevi ga jeevistaru sada kaalam ayanatho. It's up to each man and woman. You can choose what you want. That's why in that beautiful psalm 29, I love that psalm so much. I cried to God, give Yahweh, O sons of God, give Yahweh glory and all your strength used to bring glory to God. Your time, your energy, your life, when you commit to bring glory to God, you know what the Lord says? Verse 2, give Yahweh the glory due to his name. So your whole life you commit, I want to bring glory to my God. I want to live my life for glory to God. Let I become zero, I don't worry. Let the people are throwing me away, I don't bother. I become zero, people are humiliating me, I don't bother. After all, the world is humiliating, so what? Today somebody is there, tomorrow somebody says, I'm going away from you. I said, it's okay. If you are not happy, go away, it's okay. I have no problem. Wherever you are happy, be happy. Because I have not come here for anything and everything. If you want to be with me. Whatever I have, whatever God gives me, I share with you. The vision He has given me, the inspiration He gives me, the revelation He gives me, I share with you. Suppose you say, no, Father, I choose something else better. I may get better position somewhere. I say, okay, go. No problem. Be happy wherever you are. God bless you. Because we are not here for any human person. We are here because of the vision. Because of the mission. And whomever God has given will remain. That's why the Bible says that all that in the flesh passes away. It will not remain. It will pass away. All that is not up. And those who commit to do the will of God, they will remain forever. With the vision God has given to us. That's why Psalm 29 is a beautiful psalm. When I give glory to God, making glory is the purpose of my life, then when that happens, God will keep you, keep quiet? No. The voice of Yahweh is over the waters. The God's glory thunders. Yahweh thunders over vast waters. Don't touch my son. Don't touch my daughter. They are living for me. They are living for my glory. The heavens comes for you. The heaven protects you. You are in the world. You are attacked by the world. You are humiliated by the world. You are tortured by the world, but the heaven comes with a thunder. Don't touch my son. Don't touch my daughter. It's a unique experience. Verse 7, the voice of Yahweh breaks forth with the flashes of fire. The voice of Yahweh makes the wilderness quake. Yahweh is shaking the wilderness of Kadesh. The voice of Yahweh makes the oak shudder. Yahweh strips the forest bare, and in his temple all cry, glory, glory, glory. When the man recognizes, in spite of all that, how my God is protecting me, and he begins to cry, glory, glory, glory. And when that happens, may Yahweh give his people the strength. May Yahweh bless his people with the peace. It is there man realizes what is the strength of God? What is the peace of God? There, the strength of God and peace of God abides in the life of man. So the third stage is you live as you desire, as you take decision, as you make your decision. Either you spend your time with the word of God and enjoy what the heaven gives you, that becomes your delight, that becomes your power, that becomes your joy, and with that you also receive a mission and you come. You enjoy God and you receive a mission from God and you work and face all the problems, and you with the glory of God you continue to serve until God wants you to serve. And then you realize the glory, the peace and the strength of God is your life. Okay? So we shape, the third stage is we shape our destiny by the decisions we make every day. Through worship, prayer and intimate relationship with the Lord, you can change your destiny and the destinies of your families, the destiny of your cities, wherever, whatever may be. Come, let us reason together. God said in Israel, speak to God in the place of intimacy and let him rearrange your future. When your time, kindly read Amos chapter 5 verse 4. He says, I will go to wilderness. I will catch my beloved. I will be a husband for you. You know what is a husband for a woman? A husband is one who is supposed to protect her, provide her, and lead her. And God will do for those who choose him. I will be a husband for you. That makes it very clear of what God can give it for those who are born of God.
My dear friends, Sangamam Plus TV is God's gift for you for our times. Like, comment, share and subscribe. God will do wonders in your life. Praise the Lord.